see his motivation is unquestioned.
Rowe won the faceoff cleanly. Coverley shot it in for Toronto. Vault fell, trying to pick it up, turning to the boards. Côté now will have to stall for time. They're onside, so Adams slams it in on the net. Fantastic save. Out of the net, and Adams couldn't quite keep it in. Coverley will bring it in. By Schmelik with it. Adams comes in on Schmelik. Jitnik, the other defenseman for Buffalo, feeds it ahead, and the Sabres will skate away with it. Juno lost it. Here comes Carmelay. The defenseman is moving out. The pass. Perreault got it back to Adams. It was behind him. Perreault looked like he was going to keep going. He could have, but passed it back. And the pass was not on the mark. Johnson went in. Slammed on the brakes and the puck went by him. 4:44 left to play in the third. The Leafs. Last breath maybe coming up. Down 3-2. Gostavich rolled it in front. Ashik wanted to play it. Juno will. Found the opening easily. And it's into center ice again. 4:25. That's all that's left in this third period. Neat pass. Chopped in by Sullivan. Ashik out. Round the net. That's the puck to the far side. The Sabres are all back there. And out they come to center. Holzinger trying to split the defense. Rasmussen coming in. On the backhand again. Feeds it behind the net. Holzinger tied up. Sullivan trying to root it away from him and couldn't do it. And again he's on it. Sullivan. Coming out. 4 minutes left. Mishandled it. Recovered. Got it to center. Dumped it in. Wants to go after. Bumped by Warner trying to get in there. Sabres back. 5 of them. Steered out along the boards and stopped. Modine kept it in. Feeds it in. Thomas couldn't play it. Jitnik does. Modine went in. All Leafs are pulling out all the stops now. And they get it in there all right. Modine is in front of the net. Off his skate. He backed at it. And here's Berard. He passed it behind a goal. A crisp pass. On to that. Sundin up front. Backhander. Stop. Great pressure by Toronto. So it's iced by Buffalo. With 3 minutes. And 17 seconds left.
Steve Sullivan has been a force tonight. His hustle and his dogged determination and his resentment of Dominik Hasek is showing. And then Matt Sundin tries to wrap around. The one thing about Dominik Hasek, not many goals scored on him low. You have to go upstairs, especially if you're in close.
Sundin takes the faceoff for Toronto. Won it. Berard, he's very active the last few shifts. Tried to cut in front of the net. Sundin had to pick the puck up and give it to Modine behind the goal. It's shot by Thomas escapes. And Carpentier couldn't stop it at the line. Thomas was the only player in front of the net. The puck went through his skates. Sundin forced back. Buffalo, 5 of them. He'll have to beat somehow because they're all back there. Sundin got the center and shot it in. Hasek out the touch. Modine in after him. So is Thomas. And puck stopped by. Don't leave your seats. It'll be Jitnik who's going to get a penalty for holding. We have 2 minutes and 39 seconds remaining. Watch this.
Now, there's no doubt about this penalty as Jitnik grabs Sundin. This isn't it yet. Not yet. Now, as Sundin is trying to get a stick on the puck in scoring position, Jitnik trying to make Wade Phillips, the Buffalo Bill coach, proud of that tackle.
2:39 left. This penalty for holding to Alexei Jitnik. Sabres now talk it over. Their penalty killing roll is very heavy at this stage.
Pat Quinn stalling. He doesn't want to take a timeout with 2:39 to go. And McCurry's over there saying, if you want the timeout, I'll give it to you. But if you don't want it, let's get some boys out here.
Pressure time for Lindy Ruff. For Hasek, they've been really pressuring this goaltender the last two shifts.
Well, he has shown why he's one of the better goaltenders that ever donned the pads in this league, and the Leafs have tried to make life difficult for him.
All right, we're set to go now. Hasek having a tough night, but he's on the winning side of the ledger right now. Will he stay there? 2:39 left to play in the third. Buffalo 3, Toronto 2. This the fifth game, then Buffalo can end the series with a win here tonight. Sundin, Sullivan, Thomas. Berard is back at the point. Thomas lost it. Karpatsev is the other man out there on the power play for Toronto. 2:26 left. No time for mistakes now by either team. Sundin's shot is blocked. Good block on the shot. Berard can't stop it at the point. On the ice, Warner made a good stop on the Sundin shot. Karpatsev. Forced back by Sanderson. Berard now. It came out. Sanderson was backing up, so he'll get center. Made it in. Thomas shoots it to the boards in the corner. 1:58 left. Leafs are on. Sullivan can't center it. Sullivan again. Got it back to the line. Right there. Karpatsev. No shot. Berard shot. Missed the net. Pekka is on it. Pekka lost it, but the Sabres are going to clear it down the ice. 1:38 left. 1 minute left in the penalty. Berard. Puck locked for Toronto. Gary King. Back to Berard. Shot by Berard. Stopped and cleared by Buffalo. They're hanging on. 1:25 left. Joseph will go back in the net. Will he move now? 3-2 Buffalo. 40 seconds left in the power play. Leafs come out. Gary King on the wing. Takes it off the boards and goes in for it. Perreault knocked it loose. He has it. Didn't know he had it. There goes Joseph to the Leaf bench. The Leaf net is empty. And a long attempt. It might go in the net. The Buffalo Sabres are going to move on to the Stanley Cup Final. Short of a miracle by the Toronto Maple Leafs. Only a minute and 2 seconds remaining. Killing a penalty when the goaltender is out. We've talked about that many times. It's a chance for the Sabres to get the puck and lift it away. And what odds have you missed the net? If you hit the net, that's big bonus time, baby.
Well, I'm sure the Buffalo player that shot it, I don't know who shot it. Is it Dixon Ward? Let's have a look. All he's trying to do is get it out of the zone. Any attempt by Dixon to tell you that he was shooting at the empty net is a little bit of a exaggeration, but the Buffalo Sabres with 1:02 have got the Leafs down by 2, and Lindy Ruff looks like he's going to lead his Sabres into their 7th playoff round in his first 2 years as a coach. That is a owner's dream when you think of the money generated by home gates. And if they don't re-sign this guy in a hurry, they aren't thinking like they should. 1:02 left. A tough pill for Mr. Dryden to swallow.
18:58, then the time of that empty net goal. And Pat Quinn, not saying it's over yet, has called a timeout to talk one more time. Faceoff, of course, will be at center ice on the goal.
I think Pat Quinn's motive, but you can't arrange it, is hoping to get a whistle in the middle of that power play and a faceoff in the Buffalo zone. Then he could take the timeout, or he could change his goalie and get a break for just as long as the timeout is. But they couldn't get the faceoff, so now they take the timeout. And that is the third shorthanded goal that the Buffalo Sabres have scored in this series. And they are killers. And the fourth they've scored in the 99 playoff.
Dixon Ward got that insurance goal, and we're in the final minute of this period. The Leafs, goalie is still in. 11 seconds on the power play. The Buffalo will send them deep again. Ward from Warner. The fourth goal, a 4-2 lead, and Hasek under that one to gather it in and hang on to it. The goalie, Joseph, has gone to the Leaf bench again, but only 38.5 seconds remaining. And there's a faceoff that will come now inside the Buffalo line. Hasek held it, 4-2 Buffalo.
Darcy Regier, the general manager for Buffalo, has been much maligned along with Lindy Ruff in Buffalo by many, has to take kudos for this event. The deadline trades of Warner, Barnes, and Juneau have been three reasons why Buffalo will play in the finals.
The fans, I believe, are sensing that 38.5 seconds is just not quite enough. And they're standing and applauding this Toronto team. I think that is what is happening right now. 2 years since they've been in the playoffs. They've come to the Final Four. It's a good season. It's never great, only great when you win. And Buffalo is winning this one. Thomas, centering pass, couldn't handle. It's out over the line. 25 seconds left. Yes, it'll be Buffalo and the winner of Colorado-Dallas in the Stanley Cup Final 99. Game six of that series tomorrow at 7:30 Eastern. One last shot for the Toronto Maple Leafs. And it's tipped away to the line with 8 seconds. That's all that's left in this Maple Leaf season. Duck to Thomas in front, centered again. And 1.2 seconds remaining. And they all fall in the goal crease area in front of Dominik Hasek. The Sabres are going to move on to the Stanley Cup Final. Winners of the Eastern Conference Championship and winners of the Prince of Wales Trophy.
The finals will start, and Buffalo's going to be in them, will start Saturday in Denver or Dallas, or Tuesday, depending on how long the Colorado-Dallas series goes. If it ends tomorrow, which it could, if Colorado wins, they'll start Saturday night, will these Buffalo Sabres. In Denver. And I know that many people have said that the Western Conference Final has two teams that look a lot better than perhaps these two, but the Buffalo Sabres will be present, ready, and I think fairly competitive. It's a tall assignment to beat either one of those teams.
Dixon Ward gets the last stat. In fact, he gets the last two. The goal for the insurance and a penalty here. But the Buffalo Sabres have defeated the Toronto Maple Leafs in five games. A 4-2 score tonight to wrap up the series. And now, Lindy Ruff, Don Lever, and the rest of you guys, get ready for the Stanley Cup Final. Pat Quinn is the first one out to congratulate the Buffalo coaching staff. And there's Rick Lee, also out at Alpo Sun.
And he'll shake hands with Don Lever. They are married to sisters. One wife is going to have a little more money than the other when the playoffs are over. They were both captains of their NHL team. And they were both excellent players and now competing against each other as coaches.
And of course, you coached those two players, both captains. You had to see some leadership.
Yes, I certainly did.
There's Scott with a winning coach.
All right, here's Lindy Ruff, the victorious coach. Lindy, Ottawa in four, Boston in six, Toronto in five. You're never going to say it was easy, but you didn't think it would be this fast.
No, I never dreamed it would be this fast. You know, Toronto's got a heck of a team. I think some of the injuries they suffered down the stretch hurt them, but, you know, it was one hell of a game tonight.
First appearance in the Stanley Cup Final for the Sabres in 24 years. What's it mean to the franchise?
It's awesome. For the franchise, for the city, for all our fans in Western New York, it's a long time coming. We're going to enjoy it.
For all the pressure you were under, Lindy, how good do you feel about this?
I feel unbelievable. I don't know what to say, really. It's been awesome.
Congratulations, Lindy.
Thanks, Scott.
Bob.
You know, both these coaches have been terrific for all our staff on Hockey Night in Canada throughout the series. Pat Quinn of the Maple Leafs, and there, Lindy Ruff of the Buffalo Sabres. Now the presentation of the championship trophy.
Please stand by for the official presentation of the Prince of Wales Trophy. Ladies and gentlemen, to present the conference championship trophy, please welcome National Hockey League Senior Vice President and Director of Hockey Operations, Colin Campbell. Accepting the trophy on behalf of the Buffalo Sabres is Michael Pekka. Congratulations.
Dominik Hasek, the winning goaltender tonight. Dom, you were here last year in the Final Four, fell a few games short against the Washington Capitals. Is the lesson here that you guys got the message last year?
Yeah, for sure. This year we were a much more focused team, and it wasn't enough for us, you know, just to reach the conference final. We want more this year, and we were much more concentrated for these games, and that's why we won tonight.
All sorts of talk about your injury. At what percentage did you play at in the games you were in?
I mean, once I get on the ice, you know, I don't think about my injury, and today I felt great. I felt great last two games, and I feel almost 100%.
Thank you, Dominik. Congratulations on the win and your appearance in the Stanley Cup Final. And so the Buffalo Sabres are on their way to the Stanley Cup Final for the first time in 24 years. More in a moment.
Buffalo Sabres win in five games to move on to the Stanley Cup. Here are the 4-3 stars tonight: Erik Rasmussen, Curtis Brown, and Steve Sullivan. And here's Buffalo captain Mike Pekka with Scott Oates.
Ron, thank you very much, Mike. An average of one loss per series to this point in the playoffs. Did this surprise you?
Well, I think anytime you go through and you don't have those expected six and seven game series, it's a little surprising because our conference had great parity throughout the year. A lot of the teams were so closely matched, and you know, we just got hot early. I think that was the big thing. We got hot early. Boston was a team that worked extremely hard. And against Toronto, we just, uncharacteristically, were putting a lot of pucks in the net by a great goaltender. And it's one of those things where our team, when we get hot, we can be a pretty good team. And we've proved it throughout the year, and it was good to get hot right now.
Who do you want to face in the final, Dallas or Colorado?
Well, I don't know. It's going to be extremely tough, whoever they are. It's been fun watching their series. Boy, they're really battling hard. And whoever comes out is going to be a well-deserved team, but they'll both be tough, and we'll just sit and wait.
Lindy Ruff, as I mentioned to him earlier, was under a lot of pressure when he took over this team prior to the start of last season. What would you say about the coaching job he's done?
Oh, it's exceptional. You know, the job he's done has been unbelievable. I think it was really important for us to make sure at that time that we kept Don Lever on the staff, and they did that. And him, Lindy, and Mike Ramsey have worked well together. Lindy's really made it easy to come to the rink every day and have fun. And with a young team and we're having fun, we're a pretty good squad, and he's really instilled that in us.
Thank you, Mike. Congratulations.
Thank you.
There's Mike Pekka, the backbone of the Buffalo Sabres. He's on his way to the Stanley Cup Final, Ron.
Thanks a lot, Scott. Here's the game-winning goal, Erik Rasmussen, just laying in the weeds. And he sneaks in. What a series he had. Here he pounces on this right after a goal had been disallowed. So great resiliency by the Buffalo Sabres. That's the go-ahead goal, made it 3-2, and Dixon Ward with an amazing empty netter. Toronto, if you go back to game one, it was a Sunday afternoon, felt a little strange. No Dominik Hasek, no Miro Chatan, and Buffalo got the victory in the first game of the series and may have put the nails in the coffin right there. All the same, a great year for the Leafs. Who'd have expected it? A hell of a run for Pat Quinn and his gang. For the Buffalo Sabres under Lindy Ruff, as Scott mentioned, this is their second shot at a Stanley Cup. Floyd Smith guided them there in 1975. So it'll be Buffalo. They'll either play on Saturday if it all ends tomorrow, or they will play the following Tuesday. And the seventh game, of course, of this series would be on Friday night. So tomorrow, 7:30 Eastern, 4:30 Pacific. Colorado leads it 3-2. We'll be on the air with game number 6. Buffalo 4-2. They're on to the Stanley Cup. For all of us, thanks for watching, and good night.